¿Qué ha hecho Tucson International Academy o qué hizo desde marzo cuando se mencionó lo de que deberíamos de estar en casa y todas las escuelas automáticamente cerraron para los estudiantes? ¿Cómo se preparó Tucson International Academy?
So, how did Tucson International Academy prepare for the pandemic when it happened so quickly? We had exactly 2 days to be notified that the schools would not be reopening after our spring break. And so we did not return for our fourth quarter of school. And what we did was gathered our leaders of the schools and jumped right into a technology platform called Khan Academy for giving our instruction. And in there are exactly already created lessons that will keep the kids moving up level by level in the different subjects that we teach. And the teachers put in their personal teaching by making videos and introducing homework packs that we have. We always use homework packs once a week. Students are given a set number of pages of work to do at home for independent practice. And the teachers went online just like this and created videos and posted them to a designated Facebook discussion group. And that has been extremely successful. Children could see their teacher, they could give likes, they could interact with, hello, how are you doing? They had every access to their teacher and to the learning that needed to be done. And it was a big change because many people we found out do not have access to multiple devices that they can access learning online. So we quickly found out who needed help and who needed devices and were able to assist. And so that was the biggest transformation in the shortest time. It took us 2 days and we were up and running. So I'm very proud of our staff and our teachers and our leaders here at Tucson International Academy.
Yo estoy súper agradecida con Tucson International Academy, Chamulita, que es uno de mis co-host, de mi conductor, el divertido, el que hace los chistes. Su hija necesitaba una computer. Su hija se graduó de Tucson International Academy, Sonia Edith. Y estoy súper orgullosa de ella, súper contenta con ustedes y agradecida porque todas las familias humildes, todas las familias que, como dices, acabas de mencionar, que no tienen todos estos, una laptop, no tienen celulares, a veces no tienen una computer, una computadora en casa. Y ustedes ayudaron en este momento tan, tan difícil que tuvieron que quedarse los niños, los jóvenes en casa. ¿Cómo salir adelante? ¿Cómo seguir con sus clases para que no repitieran otro año en el mismo grado? Entonces ustedes hicieron un excelente, excelente trabajo con ayudar a todas las familias y a muchos estudiantes de bajos recursos.
Thank you. Yes, we are very proud of Sonia, one of our graduates who we were able to assist with the device. And she actually did graduate. We did have a small graduation ceremony, all according to CDC guidelines. And it was a beautiful moment because it looked like we were not going to be able to celebrate. And fortunately for us, we found a venue that was large enough and with all the right precautions, we were able to have an actual ceremony. It was very intimate and very special for all the students and for us because we're very proud of the hard work they did. And in a way, they can feel a little robbed from that graduation moment. And so we were able to just say, nope, not you. You all get celebrated. Congratulations. Here's your parents. They're very proud of you. Here's your teachers. We're very proud of you. And we had that moment, and it was very special indeed. So I'm very proud of them. That is something that I love about what we do with our schools. We are small enough that we can individualize opportunities. And so pulling together a graduation for a smaller group of children is much easier than trying to do a multi-thousand one. And so that made a big difference. Another thing our schools do too is we are college preparation focused. And so 100% of our students get accepted to college, and as is the case for Sonia and all of her graduating class. And so doing that individual time, finding out what their interests are, and then connecting them with businesses is the name of the game for Tucson International Academy.